is success to you? So I need three people to tell me what is success. Raise your hand before you answer. Success is staying out of trouble. So I got one was doing to stay at the top, graduating school, staying out of trouble. Check me out. Forgive me, success, because we misunderstood you. We don't know you yet. They say life without a purpose is a fancy death, but we don't care about purpose. We just want the check. All we want is cheese. All we want is cash. We want to control things that we have. And that ain't bad, but it ain't right, because money without vision is a sorrowful life. And people say they marry money, it's a sorrowful wife. I hope you're getting a divorce, start fixing your sight. Your vision should be your bride, start treating her right. She waiting for you at the altar in a dress all white. And you can't come to the altar empty-handed. You gotta have a gift, because the marriage demands it. And when y'all get married, she'll take your gift and make it known to the people who's in need of it. I'm Darius Brown, I'm an inspirational speaker and an author. I'm also an inspirational artist as well. But what is success? I found out success is this. Success is only measured, I want you to hear me clear. Success is only measured by how you live out your purpose. And if you don't know your purpose, you have no chance on being successful. Success is composed of these three things. Purpose discovery, please hear me clearly. Purpose discovery, vision development, and then taking action on that vision. Maybe you guys found your purpose in this room yet. Why are you on earth? What are you here for? Why was I born? Because when you find out your purpose, you find out why you do what you do. Let me give you a tip on purpose. Purpose discovery is this. When you find your gift, something you're gifted in. I'm not talking about something you like, something you love to do, something you're passionate about. Everybody has that in this room. Everybody got something here they love to do. Something they know they can do well, and they can serve the world with it. I want you to think about that for a second. I'm not speaking up here as a coincidence. This is what I love to do. I got a gift in what? Speaking. So I'm using my gift to what? To help others. We was just watching what? Chris Johnson on TV. How much was it? 50-something?
Bro,
50-something million?
Yeah. They pay him?
For five years. 50-something million for 5 years. $30 million guaranteed. Why is he getting this? Why he getting paid this much money? That's my question. Are you talented? My question is, are you talented? Do you have a gift inside you to get to the world? I want you to do a favor for me. Look at your hands for a second. Just look at your hands for a second. I guarantee you none of y'all got the same fingerprint. None of you guys got the same fingerprint. There's 6.7 billion people on earth. Nobody got your fingerprint. So what does that say? That says that you are different regardless of what you think. Your hands show it. Your body tells you different. So why try to be like somebody else? You can be yourself. You can cultivate that gift that you have inside of you to get to the world. When you can go to school, get the right education to make that gift come to life. The second part of purpose is knowing an intention for that gift. What do I want to do with this gift? You will never be confident in your gift if you never make a decision on what you want to do. You think Chris Johnson say, man, I can play football, but I don't know if I want to go to the NFL. You think he said that? I guarantee he did. I bet you said, I'm going to the NFL. I'm going to use my gift to get there. What requires going to the NFL? From high school to college? What does it take? Dedication, commitment, training, education, perseverance. Now, if you want to do things the quick way, you want to get money the quick way, you want to control people, but not control our gift to get to the world. We want to fight people, but in our reality, we don't have problems with other people. We got problems with ourselves, so we take it out on other people. example. There's only 5 ways you can impact people. I want you guys to pay attention to this. I found this out and blew my mind. 5 ways that people are impacted. Seeing, hearing, taste, touch, smell. That's the only 5 ways human beings are impacted. So that means the only 5 ways you can impact somebody with your gift is through the 5 senses. Think about it. The clothes you're wearing, first of all, they make you feel good in an environment. Am I right? The cologne you put on to make you smell good. The food you eat, it tastes good. The music you listen to, even if it's not conducive to what you're trying to do, the beat, sound good. Now you buy people's food, you buy people's music, you buy people's clothes, their cologne, their perfume, whatever it is, you buy it. Why? Because they use their gift. Now you gotta patronize it. You gotta buy it. My question is, what is that gift inside of you that people will buy? Not for you to be selfish, but to serve them. Money should not be the end goal in life. Money is attracted to your purpose being manifested to the world. Chris Johnson had to play for free in college. He got to a certain level, that money was attracted to him. And the NFL said, we gotta give this dude, he's good. He's giving his gift away for free to entertain others, to see something that was amazing. That money's attracted to that. When you chase money, you got priorities mixed up. Weed is a liability. There are 2 things in life. Assets, liability. Say it with me. There are assets. Say, well, there are assets and there are liabilities. A liability is something you gotta keep spending money on to keep going away. If you're smoking weed, right? Just an example. If you're smoking weed, you keep buying it. You keep buying it. Keep feeling the same way. That's a liability right there. Because you gotta keep spending money to feel a certain way. You can find peace in your purpose. You can find peace and confidence in what you want to do with your life. Your purpose is an asset to the world. If you don't discover your purpose, you're living a fancy death. Bad things. I'm doing what I'm doing because I want to show other young people the same thing. I'm a big brother to people that are older than me now. Because I made my mind up on who I was and where I wanted to go. So now I counsel 40 and 50 year olds. I'm not bragging on myself, I'm just giving you an example. You have an intention on what you want to do with that gift, you become influential in the world. There's no difference between you and Donald Trump. There's no difference between you and Kobe Bryant. All they did was made up their mind on what they wanted to do and where they were going. Have you made up your mind yet? If you make up your mind, this program will be the best thing for you.